Hello, all you ladybug lovers. Coming to you again with another episode of Miraculous Ladybug. This time with Season 2, Episode 18, titled Anansi. This episode comes to us with an opening showing Nino and Alia dancing in a very synchronized method, showing just how much these two are in sync, and for some of you shifters out there, how much they belong together. Adrian and Marinette look on, with Adrian having been, unable to go out because of his father's overprotective nature. Although Mr. DeGress has stated previously that he'll try to be a little more lenient with what Adrian wants to do, he still continues to be a bit of an overprotective parent. As Nino finishes up the dance routine with a little bit of flair and flourish, we are then introduced to Alia's sister, who is Beefcake. This girl is Nora, or as she goes by at her stage name, Anansi. Although she doesn't seem to kind of gather the meaning behind that name, as she's just like a spider. Whereas the deeper meaning is the mythological African trickster, Anansi. Our cast of characters highlight their interest in going out later that night to see a fireworks display that will be going on at the Paris Ferris Wheel. However, Nora is not at all okay with that. Previously, Alia has been involved in quite a wide array of, Akuma-related incidents, and Nora has become more and more overprotective of her and the family at large because of this, even going so far as to suplex a banana that she thought was fairly hostile at some point. I should take this time to note that although it isn't quite stated outright, the type of martial arts that Nora seems to be involved in seems to either be just regular, mixed martial arts, but it seems to take on more of a Muay Thai kind of look as she takes the stance, the way she holds her hands, a lot of the moves we see her do later down the line, not to mention the armband she has wrapped around her arms, are very much a staple of Muay Thai fighting. So it's a very interesting thing to note that she would be involved in such a martial art. She is also insanely fit. I'm having flashbacks to Jasper already. Nino goes on to try to say that he will be with Alia as well, and he will try to protect her. Nora scoffs at this and challenges him to an arm wrestling match to see if he's tough enough to protect her baby sister. Nino originally trying to back down, but Marinette says that Nino will win with the power of love. Ultimately, it's shown that Nino is no match for Nora whatsoever. However, using a little bit of a distraction on Marinette's part, Nino is able to overcome Nora, though it's with underhanded means. She immediately takes offense to this and gets rightfully pissed. However, ultimately, Alia says that her overprotective nature will ultimately do nothing for her, and she needs to just deal with the fact that she has her own life to live. They storm out, but ultimately this leaves Nora in a mood susceptible to Hawk Moth. Nora, relenting on the fact that her baby sister and her friends don't understand the dangers that are out there in the world, ultimately finds herself akumatized. And as our crew watches the fireworks, and Nino, kind of feeling a little bit down on the fact that, ultimately he was unable to really lend any kind of hand in the showdown with Nora whatsoever, they're taken off guard by the sudden stop of a Ferris wheel by an unknown Akuma. And Alia starts to videotape this for her lady blog. naturally, having seen this through the phone, Adrian disconnects and transforms into Cat Noir to go and help them. Nora reveals herself to Alia and the others as Anansi, and promptly dismantles their car from the Ferris wheel to make off with them. Cat Noir arrives on the scene in order to challenge Anansi, but he is pretty much overwhelmed by her great speed and strength, not to mention the multiple limbs that she has. And she ultimately dislodges the Ferris wheel and sends it careening off, with Cat Noir giving chase in order to save the people on board. As everyone makes their way out of the dismantled Ferris wheel cart, Alia is captured by Anansi, and Nino gives chase as she runs away with Alia. Marinette takes this opportunity to transform into Ladybug, and after Cat Noir uses some quick thinking in order to stop the Ferris wheel with his staff, he helps the people off and they make their way off to capture Anansi. Nino confronts Anansi, however he is ultimately unable to do anything except be saved by Ladybug. Ladybug and Cat Noir are up next trying to deal with her, but they are ultimately no real match for her in the beginning. Ladybug takes this time to kind of distract Anansi while Cat Noir tries to save Alia, only to get stuck himself. And even Ladybug is no match for Anansi and her strength, and is quickly thrown into the distance. Meanwhile, Anansi goes after Cat Noir in order to get his Miraculous. Ladybug uses her lucky charm in order to find a way out of this situation, only for it to be revealed to be a candle. Understanding what this means, she confides in Nino to help try to stop Anansi and buy some time while she gets some help from Master Fu. Anansi tries to remove the miraculous she thinks are on Cat Noir's ears, but Hawk Moth has to illustrate to her that Ladybug has the miraculous earrings, whereas Cat Noir has the ring. Nino steps in to try to confront Anansi. Meanwhile, with Master Fu, he opens up the box, and once again, we are shown the various wide array of miraculous that he still has in his possession, and tells her to grab the one she thinks most suitable for this situation. Ultimately, Marinette chooses the one that Master Fu himself is wearing. Master Fu agrees and turns over Waz to her, wondering which person she has in mind for this task. Meanwhile, Nino does his best in order to fight off Anansi, barely dodging her attacks and managing to get in some lucky shots. Ultimately, he has to be saved by Ladybug at the last second, whereas Anansi takes this opportunity to pounce on Cat Noir once again, only for him to activate his cataclysm to keep her from his ring. Hawk Moth says this is perfectly fine, as using that power will cause his Miraculous to time out all the faster, and they just have to wait him out. Ladybug turns over the Miraculous to Nino and says that she must turn it over to her after the battle is done. He is introduced to Wise and they combine into the hero Carapace. She also summons another lucky charm, which ends up being boxing gloves. Marinette uses her luck vision, I guess it's called. I'm not really sure what it, I don't remember if that vision of hers ever had anything called, but she uses this ability to kind of scope out what she needs to do. I also need to take this opportunity to say I absolutely love Nino's outfit. It's a very interesting way of going, and you know, it's not one you see very often, with the kind of hood with a cap on it and stuff. Not to mention a great use of his weapon, which is in fact the shield on his back. A lot of Captain America vibes you kind of get from it. He also goes in using a variety of kicks and blocking with his shield in order to, you know, fight off Anansi's heavy hits. Meanwhile, Ladybug takes this opportunity to form a ring, saying that she will go one round with Anansi, and whoever gets the knockout wins and, you know, either gets the Miraculous or releases the friends. They go at it with Marinette dodging out of Anansi's various strikes, causing a cave-in of the structure that they're in, bringing it down upon her. And they use this opportunity to shield both Cat Noir and Alia with Carapace's move, you know, the shell shielder, whatever it's called. I honestly need to kind of study up on the variety of moves that Carapace can pull out. With everyone emerging unharmed, it's very obvious that Alia has a bit of an idea who Carapace actually is. You know, she's just that close to Nino that it's just like he can easily see through who exactly he is. Which is even more hilarious given the fact that she's been so close to Ladybug and is such a big fan, but yet still does not realize who Ladybug truly is. Ultimately, Anansi digs herself out of the rubble only to have a cataclysm to her helmet, bringing her back to Nora. Cat Noir tries to make a run for it since he's about to time out, but Ladybug does take this opportunity to remind him that though she needed Carapace's help for this, she says that he is ultimately irreplaceable. This gives a very nice, touching smile to Cat Noir's face. And, you know, I feel like with each new battle, they deepen their bonds bit by bit. But I ultimately wonder, will they ever end up revealing who the other one is? Because it seems very odd that, you know, they can't trust each other with their secret identities. I understand it's for tension and, you know, to kind of keep the mystery going of when it'll ultimately happen. But the fact that they can keep the secret of their own identities, it kind of feels like it would do nothing but to help their cohesion and how they are able to work together if they knew who the other one is. That's just the old school, you know, Sailor Moon viewer in me talking ultimately. Because in the end, a lot of the Sailor Scales ended up finding who the other was, and, you know, that did nothing but benefit them in the long run. But Alia, ever the media junkie, takes this opportunity to try to find out who this new hero on the scene is, and naturally Nino introduces himself as Carapace, the newest hero of Paris. And as they make their leave, Nino does, you know, without a fight or anything, turn over the Miraculous back to Ladybug, as he is just happy he was able to help save Alia. He meets back up with Alia and Nora and questions whether or not they are okay. Alia does say that she's perfectly fine, and even though Nina underplays what he was able to do during this whole event, Alia says she does understand Nino's character as a whole, not giving away that she perfectly aware of who he actually is. Nino gives a bit of a nervous laugh to this situation, although I'm pretty sure he doesn't understand the full implications of what Alia had said to him. And Nora ultimately apologizes, saying that she lost the arm wrestling match to Nino fair and square. Ultimately, Marinette does apologize, saying that they used trickery in order to win, but Nora forgives them and says that ultimately it's her own fault for being overbearing, with Alia giving her big sister a nice hug, saying that she's just happy she cares for him. And the very next week, they all go out ice skating, which is a very cute way of ending this whole situation. Though I do question the fact that Nora wears her fighting gear wherever she goes. Unless this was right after another match she had, then I guess it's perfectly fine. But it was a fun to get to know yet another member of Alia's family. Like, honestly, we know so much about Alia's family at this point that it's almost ridiculous. So now we just need to get to know a little bit more about Nina's family as well. And if you ultimately do follow a lot of Miraculous Ladybug news, you knew that eventually Nina was going to become the newest hero on the block. It was just a matter of wondering when exactly it was going to happen, because honestly, episode synopses don't really give away when a new friend is going to become a Miraculous holder. But it was fun to get to see all of this, all these characters, you know, interact, you know, fight the good fight, and just show off what they could do exactly. And, you know, if you know enough spoilers, I guess I could say, you know, we just have 1/2 more Miraculous holders more than likely before the season is over, which is not so much of a spoiler in and of itself, as the opening theme kind of gives that away as well. But I'm interested to hear what you think of the newest hero, Carapace. How, you know, I really hope we get to see more and more involvements of these newer heroes, because, you know, Alia didn't even get to strut herself as Rena Rude, which is very unfortunate, but it's just like, come on, let them at least hold on to their Miraculous just in case, you know, danger happens. You know, having more heroes out there can only benefit you in the long run, but it's also a good way of making sure that, you know, fights don't become too easy, and you don't get that power creep with, you know, certain characters becoming, you know, certain enemies becoming too much of a struggle for our heroes. So it raises a lot of questions why they don't do things, but at the same time, I can kind of understand it. You know, ultimately it becomes an ensemble piece, whereas we're at most trying to focus specifically on Ladybug and Cat Noir, but I don't mind it becoming that way. You know, you've done so much to establish your side characters and even bring them into the fold that I want to see them have more heroic moments and do more in general. But, you know, tell me your thoughts in the comment section below. Leave me a like if you liked what I had to say about this episode, or a dislike if you didn't. Let me know where I stand. And subscribe for more episode reviews of Miraculous Ladybug. Thanks for joining me.